Hello and welcome. Recently, YouTube has announced that every creator on its YouTube partnership program, regardless of their location in the world, are going to be required to provide their US tax info. These details have to be submitted by the deadline of May 31st. Failure to do so may result in deductions to the tune of 24% from the worldwide earnings of the content creator in question. The tax withholding requirements may differ depending on your country of residence, whether you're eligible to claim tax treaty benefits, and whether you identify as an individual or a business. Indian creators, thanks to the Double Tax Avoidance Treaty or the DTAA between India and the US, will have to pay around about 15% of their YouTube ad revenue coming from their US viewers.
Mr. Courtney
has had decades worth of experience working with taxation, corporate laws, as well as commercial laws. He's also had experience working with intellectual property rights. Sir, if we could please have a very brief overview of what the new regulations entail and what the policy change is going to mean for people using the platform, as well as what the tax deductions are going to look like.
Right, Sri Rupa. Basically, in my view, there is no new regulation. Regulation is intact. It's the direct tax law of the US, the IRC, which is nothing but the Internal Revenue Code, and which is administered by the IRS, Internal Revenue Service. So when any income is originating in the US, the US government wants to tax that income at the source itself, right? So therefore, now in the new technology world, the technology companies, when they are operating in multi-jurisdictions, when content is being collected and broadcast back and forth between different jurisdictions, these issues are all emerging in the new technology regimes. So therefore, YouTube, for its customers, it has come up with an advisory and also a guideline and also a regulation that you need to give tax information about your earnings from the US audiences. Because when you are putting content on the YouTube, it can be heard or seen by different persons in different jurisdictions. But then this is specific to the US. So whatever is the US audience, the income which is being generated from that, that will be subject to taxation. Now the whole issue is how much tax to pay, who is the content creator, whether he's an individual or a business entity, what is the rate of taxation to be paid, whether these two countries, for example, India and US in this example, do have a double taxation avoidance agreement. If yes, what is the nature of the income, whether it is royalty or business income. So on all these factors, the tax deduction will be determined. So therefore, this is what is the basic structure. And what I understand is from June onwards, it will kick off.
Right, sir. It's from what I understand, a deadline has also been announced for May 31st, by which time the details also have to be submitted to Google.
Correct. Because those details are nothing but the details of earning. What are you earning in that particular jurisdiction or the market? So therefore, that information will give YouTube as to how much is to be deducted and paid to the US government, right? And as a proactive, what you call content creator, you need to be aware of the double taxation avoidance agreement and also how you raise invoices, what you describe, whether it is you describe it as a business income or royalty. And if it's royalty, then you need to get the tax residency certificate also from the income tax department, which can be given to YouTube, based on which they can deduct at concessional rate of 15% TDS. TDS is nothing but withholding tax. Tax reduction at source, as we call in India commonly. Right. Internationally, it is called withholding tax.
Right. So that gives us a very holistic and good understanding of how it's going to impact content creators with viewership in the US in general. But what about specifically content creators who hail from India and may have a viewership in the US? How is it going to directly affect them?
Look, there are two kinds of responses I can give for this. Yes, definitely there's an impact. If any Indian content creator is generating views in the US, and if he is doing 100% viewership from US, then the entire income is subject to deduction at source or withholding, right? And that Indian entity or individual should get the tax residency certificate from the Government of India Income Tax Department and give it to the YouTube, so that the rate of tax, as I said earlier, 15% only, right? So this being the answer in a more regulatory environment, keeping the regulatory environment in mind, that can be the answer. But we have to look at the impact in real sense. What I understand is that US viewership for Indian content is not even 10 to 15%. So it means 85% of the content is either viewed within India or other jurisdictions. So the financial impact may not be that much. That's my view.
I understand, sir. So from what you're saying, basically, it's going to be the impact on the whole is going to be very less. Despite that, sir, I want to ask you, is there any way of minimizing that impact for content creators?
As I told you, the way to minimize the impact is to understand the double taxation avoidance agreement between India and US and look at it more carefully. Look at what head of income will book it under. For example, royalty will entail a 15% withholding tax. So you must describe it as a royalty for your content in your invoices which you are raising. So also, it also depends upon whether it's an individual or a business enterprise, right? So therefore, if it's a business enterprise and you are not giving any tax residency certificate and you are not going through the double taxation avoidance route, then the tax rate may be around 30%. And if it's an individual, it is 24%. So therefore, it is better to bill as an individual if you don't have the compliances to get the tax rate benefit, a lower rate of tax marginally. That's my view.
Right, sir. I'm sure it's very helpful for any content creator watching.
Yeah,
my final question is, right, sir, I'm sorry to interrupt.
No problem, because most of the content creators are individuals and they're not people who have a commercial or a corporate understanding. So it is better that they apply themselves a little more, because it's a hard-earned money for them. So therefore, any money, any deduction of tax, you need to be very, very careful. You have to keep the impact as minimum as possible. That is possible only when you follow the regulations and follow the procedures and give the required documents. For example, if you don't submit the tax information to YouTube, you will end up paying large amount of taxes. Similarly, if you don't give the tax residency certificate and all, again, the tax impact would be there. The third is that if you don't categorize yourself properly as an individual or a business entity, then also there'll be an impact. So the content creators need to be very careful, and they should do a tax planning going forward when this requirement by YouTube is flagged off in June.
Right. Do you think that there's going to be a long-term impact beyond what we can expect just from this announcement that's recently been made? Also, does this set a precedent for other platforms which are similar to YouTube? Will they also, do you think, come out with similar measures?
Yeah, normally, any taxation regime would have a fairly long-term impact only, because all the governments, irrespective of which country, wherever in the world, they're looking at revenue maximization. And all the SSCs, wherever they are looking at revenue optimization. So that tug of war will go on, but at the end of it, the content creators need to be very careful and take it in their mind that assume that it is going to be a long journey and long-term impact, and they should put their house in order and do maintain documents properly, give information properly to the YouTube, tax information, and maintain all the records and returns properly to avoid the impact, which is more than what can be done as a moderate one. The law is law. If it's the US law to require all the platforms on the internet to collect and determine what is the income being generated in the US,
Thank you so much. That was very helpful. It's clarified a lot of different points. Also, we got an insight into what the future is going to look like. So,
yeah, thank you.
It's been very helpful, sir. And great to have you on board. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Sri Rupa.
Thank you so much, sir.